God damn. Watch a man on fire. Love it, a legacy. What are you doing? Damn.
Louder! The gunshot holds up there! frequency. In fact, it's the sound that sets you free. You are prisoning on this block until that sound sets you free. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you set?
So the Seahawks take a round, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Alert, 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 alert. 48,
come on. That's a conky guy.
Yeah, let's give Sack lunch.
49, check 49, check 49. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Michael Dixon, the kickoff.
Each team's
Seattle.
Headed, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
No, you said 5 seconds. Now that's 6 seconds ago. 6 seconds. 10 seconds ago. Okay, the next 10 seconds is your smile.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And that last drive, do they stick with it?
I would think that they would, because why would you change anything?
Listen for the sound. You don't anticipate. Concentrate on the sound. You understand it? We're getting it on you.
Go.
That call makes sense because they've been doing it well on this drive. And once again, they showed passing formation, showing shotgun, then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Set up the screen to Ray. Able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
Nice little lead.
Kevin Six on the screen. That's third down.
Makes it
second
and 2.
That might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
They were having some problems with the Royal Family.
Mike 54. Man, I got you.
What?
Check. Crunch.
The question is that anyway.
Check out
history. Ancient history. No more questions. What else?
Who's your very first girlfriend?
None yet. None you do.
Here's Murray. Just inside the 10. He gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. And they got 3 yards. That's enough for conversion, and now it's first and goal.
Ask you what?
Stop
3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd and 10.
Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home, yo.
Nice play there to swallow
check
the ball.
Check
on second. Strike. two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for carrier. The Cardinals on third down.
The 18-yard line.
Four for four thus far. This is third and eight.
Third and eight.
All I was thinking was, if we could take them back together, I wouldn't be able to play piano, but I could still swim. Sam, get back.
Throwing now is Murray. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And snapped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. Over the corner on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
It's a play call. Since the screen pass was available, whenever you get a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
That's good. I just had a coke. All right, this teacher, this famous teacher, teaches a lot of rich kids, and all that, right? You belch every few minutes while you're practicing.
Okay.
You apologize to him, but you keep belching. You'll offend every sensibility he had, right?
Right, Sam. But he's going to be taken down behind the line of scrimmage.
Behind the line.
It's
going to
go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and goal on the Seahawks 4 yard line.
56, Mike, 56. Oh, here we go.
And he's maybe going to get this back to the floor, but that's not all.
Bucked down right at
two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, you go to the air.
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going to play action since you ran it twice. But I often think the second down is the time you go play action, throw the ball. I say commit to the run. Think about getting more into territory.
He's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. He'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a fourth down. Well, let's see what they do. They're knocking on the door here in the second quarter.
And you know what you look at on your play sheet? Your two-point conversion plays. Because you've drawn up a number of them in today's football. You don't just have one or two for the game. You have like six or seven. Which one do you like here? Because that's essentially what you're going for right now. That spot on the field, call one of those and go get six.
So it's an old-school extra point that counts three times, and certainly a disappointment they weren't able to get it in the end zone.
Yeah, I can just imagine post-game, head coach
Bear
looking
catch,
at the box
made
score,
of the
19-yard
yard line,
grimacing a little
you're
bit,
Seahawks
but happened to realize it at that moment,
at their own
getting 3 points is
vital.
Go ahead and get the points, put them on the board.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time they clocked it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal.
Could you sense the relief when they only gave up the field goal? And they were able to try back to the line. This try was the next step because they didn't close their team at the touchdown. But they didn't know they were going to go. They didn't have a second chance.
It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First down, Seahawks.
And lets it fly for Lockett. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way in, touchdown.
Complete to number 16, Tyler Lockett.
63 yards. And the Seahawks able to lose a close game again. And this is a good gun to make it a 17-14 game.
Cardinals 17, Seahawks 14.
Let's take a big shot downfield. Didn't get it on that one. They may come back to it again.
Time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for an offensive rebound. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Aldrich Rosa set to kick off.
One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Drive the Seahawks offense. They're down now 24-14. Work to do as they come up on a first and 10.
I got you, boy. Let's go. Double count right here. Double count. Right left.
Defense, let's go.
Play clock down to zero. And this is not the way to start a drive. And that'll set a back.
Let's go.
So the illegal forward pass also costs him a down, and now it's second and long. Wilson, after the play fake to Carson, steps away to his left. And that one goes incomplete. He's made it lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Yes, we have one. Hot.
Go. Take it. 36. Sponge. No.
Alert.
Switch. Under crunch. Not right there. Under crunch.
Check 15. Dancing to his left. Oh, he tries to get it to Metcalf, but it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27, and he'll get this back down to about the 12-yard line.
Intercepted.
Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter for the interception, and now a chance that they can be even in the air hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man. And he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
This real. Hello. Yeah. Listen, I need to drive somewhere.
No. Fine.
He's got a back ticket, heart condition. Look, he's a nervous kid. He doesn't have a spot in stress.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10.
Stop your whining. He's crashing. He's checking crash.
Use the maids, but in a couple of
minutes. No gain on the play there. Brandon Wall carrier.
Sometimes with the running game, you just got to stick with it. This is third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Here we go again.
And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It's just a game of one down, and now it's third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? There working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on third and eight.
56, the mic, boys. 56, check 56.
And he'll take this one out for the Arizona touchdown. Kenyon Drake, his second touchdown of the afternoon.
Cardinals 31, Seahawks 14. Aldrich Rosas set
now
to kick
off. Now after
the
touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. And this
the
will
Seahawks
be a touchback as it sails over the end line.
At their own 25-yard line.
You took my money. Mr. Ramos.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive or not?
I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
You want to attack the Seahawks,
how may attack them here?
I wish we had
done something. Pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Good job right there.
No,
just too late.
Gun. Give me some.
Here's Carson. He's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Carrier.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defense tackle of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first yard. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And he will get him down a couple yards shy of the first down carrier. Nice tackle coming up from his free safety spot. Call it a gain of five. Right there now.
It's now fourth down.
Now a deep run near midfield. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
To Jared Cook.
A curious decision
a
to go for
16
it, but
yards.
It pays off with a first down.
First down, Seattle.
Hey, we're going to
Mike the 48 right now. Let's go.
I'm coming. Touch.
Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right. Tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. They've really distanced themselves.
So definitely have them in the rear view mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives to end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. Second and nine.
Check Mike 54. Mike 54. It's just me and you. It's just me and you.
Right back to Drake. And he'll go out of bounds after getting this across the 15. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give them a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
56 by 56.
Watch the slant. Watch the
first down. Drake. And he'll power his way up near the 25.
Kenyon Drake, the ball carrier.
Get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
It's a pickup of six.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you
want to
run the
second and a short.
Ball is 24-yard line. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Mike's by four.
Watch the pass.
Switch.
Running, it's Drake. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 12 yards there on the first down. Well, CD, a lot of times, like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's going. We know that he's fast into the open field. But, man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield. But also, when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. And flags come in as he gets forward for about 3 yards. And let's check on the call.
We played to win.
So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Now Murray's going to set up the throw. He's going to loft one deep over the middle into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Joel Adams. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
By the Seahawks.
They needed a break. They need to make a difference. Defensively, they need that. Now they're running on the play and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
14,
now here's
14,
a first and 10 at the 38.
Here we go. 48. Hey, zero.
We ain't giving up nothing.
Good time.
After the interception, here's Wilson. That's into the hands of Carson. Flash the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stop short of the 2 yards
on the pickup.
That catch good for only a couple.
At the 36-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 36 on second and 8.
Hey, you don't want to see.
Listen.
You don't want it. 25!
Now it's Wilson. They'll run the screen with Carson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly run down. A nice little game.
Carson.
Lucky on my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
A lot of people are looking for you. Mariana Garcia Guerrero.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Hey, alert 48!
Play action. Now Wilson sliding out of the pocket. And he finds Carr. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. His second catch of this wild card game, and he goes for a first down.
Check 48 to Mike.
You can't believe
that you played. On first down, Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
We got this.
Politics, high-ranking government officials, corrupt police, and organized crime.
1 quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
You're a stranger, Daniel.
So the signs of life and what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. It's Carson, and he stopped immediately.
Carson, the ball carrier.
Give the tag to Hassan Reddick.
In on the tackle.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose
second
the run
and
flies in like a missile.
At the 17-yard line
of scrimmage.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Watch safety creeping. Safety's creeping. Showing it.
Yeah.
Showing it.
I'm done with killing. I told you that.
Okay. Anything else? It's yours.
Right left. Right left. He's mine. He's mine. Good job right there. Good job right there.
Stay. Rush coming in. He's taken down. Hassan Reddick picks up his second sack of the afternoon. These pass rushers have to be salivating and just pin your ears back time indeed.
Hey, check 20.
Got it.
Check four.
Zebra.
Check six guys.
He won't be close to a first down as he runs it right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
It's now fourth down.
Fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
Three down.
Mike, 30 guys. Four down.
You run. 35 to Mike. Watch the screen. Pass.
They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. Oh, he's got some breathing room.
Wilson
able to make something
keeper.
Out of nothing there.
On,
17
first
yards
goal.
And a first
Seattle.
Down.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it.
Gotta go, in and out, let's go.
First and goal, and they gotta be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D.
This play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11.
Isaiah Simmons.
So a loss of five, and that'll be second down.
It's a loss of five.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
So they get pushed back to the 11. And here's second and goal.
Hey, alert.
Jim.
All goes special.
Coming to you.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Jalen Thompson picks it. And he will take it out to the 25-yard line.
Intercepted.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And you'd have to say they have done what they set out to do with this wild card round. It won't get easier from here, of course, but they'll certainly have... Weaving through traffic, and now he's free! Touchdown, Cardinals! Kenyon Drake saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Cardinals push further out in front.
Up for
well,
the
look, this
point.
Is a team, Charles. They faced adversity all year long. They're putting it all together here in the wild card game.
Feels like
good.
A statement, doesn't it? An absolute statement game.
Score,
a
Cardinals
message to the top seeds. Overlook us at Jordan Carroll. We're pretty darn good.
Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll take it a yard or so past
Tyler
the 20, call it the 21.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
Seahawks offense. They are most likely staring at a cold end of their season in this wild card round. Nothing has gone right so far. They are, to be frank, in desperation mode now as Amy. And his pass is intercepted for the third time. Buda Baker with a pick. Buda, they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Just another reason to celebrate there on the defensive side with the interception. And this is a game that they clearly have firmly in their grasp.
A lot of handshakes, a lot of hugs, a lot of smiles. It's been their day.
56.
After the turnover, here's
Warren.
Smith pitches left side. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. It's a gain of 11 and a Cardinal first down.
When someone throwing it that well, that
first and 10, you know, the 15-yard
line. Turn TV down. Never mind, my fucking phone died. I don't know how.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
Let's go.
A quick throw complete out to Isabella. Now a loose football. The ball comes out. Thankfully for the offense, fortuitous bounce there. The ball goes out of bounds because they're down here in the red zone.
You don't want to lose one. And the best part, because it went out of bounds, they retain possession, still have an opportunity to put points on the board.
Check tight. Check tight. Bang, 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 bang.
Second and five now. Murray. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line.
Emerson Griffin
brought down. Able to take him down. It's a loss of three.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
The Cardinals on third down. They've been outstanding. 7 first downs and 8 tries. This is third and 8. Buying time to his left. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. And he moved left there, Charles Little. Danger playing. He didn't throw to the left side, went over the middle. Got the score.
Told him as a kid, don't touch the stove because it might be hot. He touched it anyway.
Hey, Legacy, bring me my charger down here.
Seahawks, good with the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Seahawks take over first and 10. At their own 19-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And at this point, maybe you say, really just to make the playoffs. They couldn't win their division, but did earn a wild card berth. It does appear, however, that their season is just a few minutes away from ending in one and done fashion. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. First and 10 as they search for a score. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. What a nice little game.
Jalen Thompson on the tackle.
Options galore here. Second and a few inches.
It's second and inches at the 39-yard line.
Now it's Carson, and they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. It's a loss of four and a third down.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game, and all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
McCord's going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now.
Three down.
Escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Shotgun. Wilson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
That's where you want to go with the ball initially, so he's trying to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Tiny's on Ringo. Tiny.
12. Wilson. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And it'll bring up third down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone and the frustration of mine tonight. We're just happening everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer this way.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. Defensively, you look at the numbers. Another incomplete pass that we just saw, and they're under 200 yards passing for the game, so they've done their job on that side of the ball.
Recently, I was actually working a game where a quarterback had a streak of 5 straight games without a 200-yard game, and that was a big talk both in his town and amongst his team. How do we get the passing game going? So big credit to them, holding them under 200 today.
The 3 straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go on 4.
Got three down.
Left side complete to London. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on 16 yards. Felt compelled to go for it there on 4th down, trailing in the 4th quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a 4th down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You stopped to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Tight is right.
Hey, 0-0-0.
Action. It's Wilson. Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
I'm not going to throw a pick to you, dummy. Stupid. You're funny.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Alert! Three down!
Front left!
Check! Under 10! Check 52!
Gotta go, in and out, let's go! Move 15!
To throw again. Wilson. And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Russell Wilson going to get a timeout. Somewhat pointlessly vain yard. 3 seconds to go.
You think you got...
We got glitched, D?
Let me block it real quick just to shut you up.
Check! Watch the end! Check! Lucky!
Good job right there! Whip!
Watch the whip!
Four down! Good job right there!
One last shot for Wilson. Flush that right. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. As time has run out on this football game. Our season ends here. A tough way to go out.
And the goal was to not just get to the wild card game, which they did, but to win it. And so now, how negative do you look at that? They got there, had an opportunity. And for some teams, they have to lose games like this before they learn how to win them in later seasons.
Legacy!
For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon.
run. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more,
yo, can you tell her to bring my charger down here? Call her. She ain't got fucking goddamn thing. You charger don't charge my phone. Oh, damn. See, it's not gonna charge it. I need my charger. What the fuck is wrong with this phone? Why won't it turn on? Hey, call my phone. Cause his light keeps blinking like it's on, but it's dead. Or at least it fucking said it was dead. Nothing is coming on. Call my phone. Like it's not even wanting to connect, like it's charging. She's been upstairs for over an hour. It does matter. For an hour? For an hour? No, I don't. Carlos called me and my phone died. I need to call him back, see what he wants. Where? I need my charger. Where's my box? God dang it. If I ask you for my charger, that means I need my charger. Jesus. Damn, give your mom her shit back. Give her her charger back. It's right here. Nothing, Legacy. Because you acting real retarded right now, baby. This is fucking crazy, bro. Nothing is happening. Like, nothing. Like, my screen's black. My phone is on, bro. I can't do anything. The only thing that keeps lighting up is these buttons up top. I mean, this light right here. What the fuck is wrong with this piece of shit? And I can't take the back off, can I? Fuck no. We got a needle, toothpick or something. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with this shit. I did that. It's not, nothing is coming on my screen. It's just staying black. It's making the vibration and all that shit. What? Throw this motherfucker into a wall. I don't know why I should doing this shit now. I ain't got no way to get nowhere no more.
happening, yeah. Drip, little bit, let me feel myself a little bit, you ain't talking big, get out my way, little bit.
Oh, Jesus.
For a coup, for a season, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls, head to toe, designer.
You talking about hold down the Bixby button and the power button? Or the volume button? Because all it's doing is just make it vibrating one time. This shit is fucking, I don't know if it zapped out, the screen's fucked up or what. But you can't call it. What, it just kept ringing? I don't know what the fuck this shit is. This shit's stupid. Like, literally, I went to go answer the shit, and then this motherfucker just, like, died the fuck out all of a sudden, randomly. Like, it's not like it's dead. It's, I don't know what the fuck happened to this shit. Go bring me a cookie, baby. Are the cookies out? Well, warm me up one. God damn it, man. I'm about to throw this piece of shit. Why not? Alright, whatever, Legacy. God damn. Okay. We got any extra phones? Cause this shit ain't gonna fucking end up fixing itself. Goddamn phone.
Well,
I told you, you start getting fucking annoying.
Okay, well, you spend all day in a room. What do you expect?
Sit down. What you mean here?
Use it.
For what?
Don't you need to call Carlos back?
I was gonna say, we're just not even calling back.
Why would you not just call him back?
Because my fucking phone don't work, honey. Two, five, two, two, is that it? Yeah, I think so. Oh, you got Carlos's number saved in your phone?
Actually, I have
What'd you do? My phone went haywire. What is it? What are you talking about? No. That's what I'm saying. They didn't have none of that stuff moved and out. After I got down there Friday to walk the floor with them, I told them I was going to pick up the machine. I told them what I wanted to get done Thursday. Then when I got down there, he was like, oh, that's not a priority for me right now. I just want to get the hallway all the way done and all that. So then he was like, I told him if he could have them clear out some of the rooms so that way I didn't waste my time getting the machine. And then he was like, he'll have Jose clean out a couple of the rooms. But they didn't clean out none of the rooms. They didn't get nothing out of the way. And did nothing I asked them to do. Because I even went down there Saturday. Huh? Just the new rooms outside. I think it's like 7 rooms. The rest of the inside, I had a
where we stopped in the hallway and sprayed. Everything I did today was the hallway that we didn't spray because he told me to stop. So I had to spray, I had to grind it, spray it, and then seal it. So it was basically from the middle of the building almost all the way down to the other end. It was just hallway. And then one of the balcony areas, whatever, where the staircase is.
So I hadn't been down before?
No. I had down upstairs, but they ended up putting that wood floor over it. They're doing, but that's what I was saying. It was wasting my time getting a machine. I'm gonna see if they won't charge me anything for it on the rental, or just charge me half a day for the vacuum, but don't charge nothing for the machine because literally didn't use it for maybe 10 minutes. Ran down the hallway real quick over 300 because I had already ran the machine over it before. I just never got to spray it, spray to seal it. Just did that to clean it up, but I would have done the whole hallway from one end to the building, but those pictures I sent you, I sent to him and told me not to do it until after Monday or something. Because I told him it needed to be resprayed. If not, he's going to have blotchy spots all over, and those rings from the buckets are going to show through. So I'm saying, I don't know what they're doing. They're starting to get all discombobulated down there. Keep making trips down there for nothing.
So, all right
then.
What'd you do? What buttons did you hit?
Because I hit this and this, and I almost hit that, and that, yes I did, I held this one, and these two buttons down. I did that, and all it kept doing was that over time, so I did that before. You look crazy. You look sick.
No, she did her own makeup. Come on, she keep me look so
beautiful. You do look beautiful. Oh, your hair is falling in the way.
Yeah,
my hat now. See, it's crazy because your phone call came through, so my phone didn't die. This shit went fucking haywire. This shit retarded. Stop filling your big ass thing up with the water bottle. I had to go get our fucking food and shit earlier.
Hold on.
The hell?
Let's rewind here.
Jesus.
Let's rewind here.
The fuck you want me to do?
Let's rewind here. Look at me.
Nope, I'm not looking at you.
Look at me.
Nope, I'm not looking at you.
I'm not going to have a serious conversation right now.
I ain't looking at you. Stop, girl. What's wrong?